to Spectacular! Yeah! Thank you, Josh. That's Josh. He's also doing sound and light tonight, so thank you.
Yay!
I know all of you, which is awesome. Thank you so much for coming. I'm Randy Wood. I'm the host. And we got lots of fun stuff tonight. It's going to be a very fun, silly show. I'd like to thank the Pocket Theater because they're just such a great space to do stuff like this in. I'm excited because this is my birthday weekend. I'm very excited. Sunday, I'm going to be 48. I might as well just say it. You know, it's no
oh my God, you don't look 48.
We practiced that all week. I've been doing silly comedy for a while now. I remember when I first decided that I wanted to do comedy, like in my early 40s, I was talking to my therapist, and she's like, well, why don't you just do it? And I said, I don't want people to laugh at me. And she laughed, like you just did, and it took me a minute to be like, oh, that's what's been holding me back for so long. And I did stand-up comedy for a while, and it's very challenging. I feel like I only had one good joke ever, and it was about a futon, and it's just that's hilarious right there. And it's just the idea when you're young, like when I first moved out of the house, like a futon was so exciting. It represented so many possibilities. I'm like, it could be a couch, it could be a bed, I could sleep on the floor. This is so the future. You know, it's just such a cool thing. And the funny thing about futons is they don't age gracefully. And there's a point in which you realize you're just sleeping in a nest of like dirty clothes in the corner. You're like, and then you know, years go by and you realize a futon is just a bed that's given up, you know, it's just like, fuck it. There's always that crack in the middle, you know, of a futon, when you're sleeping on the futon mattress, that just, it doesn't matter how you sleep, you just always kind of get sucked into it. It's like a black hole. It's like you wake up in the middle of the night, you have to wedge yourself out of it. And they're so hard to move. It's just depressing and sad. And I hate futons. So, that's my futon joke. And that's why, you know, I hate futons. I sleep in bed now like a normal human being. And on that note, guys, are you ready for a show? Are you ready for a super awesome, amazing show? All right, let's give it up for our first act of the evening, Wonder Vermin!
Welcome to Up Close and Magical, the highest rated close-up magic podcast on iTunes.
Yes!
We are performing in front of a live audience today. Now, today, our guest is the mysterious Flick Butterman. Thanks, Flick, for being here.
Thank you, Gray, for having me.
And we are going to be starting off, as usual, with a trick in our card trick corner, where our magicians blow us away with their incredible sleight of hand. What have you got for us, Flick?
Oh, Gray. Lend me, not to be cliche, but will you pick a card and show it to the audience?
Oh, coming out strong, fresh out the gate. I am showing my card to the audience.
Okay, nobody say it.
Now, I put the card back in the deck and watch my signature shuffle.
Wow. For you folks listening, this is a visually intricate trick.
Yes, I just brought the cards to life and made them fly around the room and return to my hand, and then I
pulled the card from behind my ear. Yes. Amazing. Yes. Amazing. Yes. Incredible. Yes. I will never know how you did that.
Oh, well, it's a real mystery. But for my next trick, I will be needing my two lovely assistants.
Now welcome Flick's lovely assistants, Candy and Brandy. Yes!
As I am always...
Take that, it's a lob.
As I am always saying, a candy is dandy, but brandy will stab you.
That's right.
Now, as Flick and Candy are tying Brandy up, I'd like to take a moment to remind you of our sponsors, the Walter Drake Catalog, your one-stop shop for everything from wide calf compression socks to pet gravestone markers that say, if love could have saved you, you would have lived forever. Cups, exceptional values, guaranteed. And Blue Apron. Now back to magic.
As you can all see, Brandy is clearly inescapably bound in magician-grade rope. And she has been dropped into a piranha tank just full of piranhas. And she only has 23 seconds to escape before they devour her beautiful face. Brandy ready? A Brandy go!
Now, for you listening who can't see this, Brandy is tied up like someone truly tightly tied up. She is dodging piranhas left and right.
Ooh, whoa!
Time is running out.
Ooh!
Will she make it?
Ooh.
And she's done it, folks. Incredible. Incredible.
Oh, yes, Brandy is astounding and dangerous.
Now that's what I call good podcasting.
Oh, now that is just good magic.
That's right! Yes!
But I hear it's nothing compared to the illusion you have for us next. Now, Candy, and only Candy, will be sawed in half. But the mysterious Butterman is taking it one step further by foregoing any sort of shielding as her midsection is sawed in twain.
Now, witness as I perform this a mind-blowing stunt, as I saw Candy and only Candy in half with this very real, a very sharp, a saw. A saw, a saw. The deed is done!
Woo! Yes!
Wow.
Whoa!
Sawed in half.
A Candy, how do you feel?
Like just one hungry person who's just been sawed in half.
A wiggle your toes?
Ooh.
Ooh.
Wow. Once again, I will never know how you did that.
Thank you, Greg. Now let's get you patched up now, Candy.
Thank you to the mysterious Flick Butterman for being on the show. If you want to see more of Flick Butterman, follow his YouTube channel. Just search, I can't believe it's not Butterman. As always, I've been your host, Greg Fleesman, and this has been another episode of Up Close and Magical. Rate, review, and subscribe, and remember, keep the magic close.
I am not a plant!
We're messy, gross, and stressed out humans, so why not take a crack at being vermin?
Disrespect us, and you'll get punched.
When you turn around, you'll nibble your lunch.
A raccoon!
A rat!
And a little squirrel!
A possum!
Or a rat!
Easier than being girls! So, we're creepy, crawly creatures of the night. We're wonder vermin. Come take a bite.
What up, bitches? Yeah, you know that I'm a squirrel, turning nuts into a necklace like a fucking strand of pearls. I live in the wild and I'm scared of your pets. Fill up your bird feeder, I'll be all set. I chew through your wires and I nest in the walls. I can't go for shit, so give me a call.
Ooh, wonder vermin. Ooh, don't turn the stove on.
I'm a motherfucking rabbit, so you know what I do. I got 29 kids, and they do too. I'm the symbol of fertility and animal testing. Bucks and does up in my brood, and ain't nobody arrested. I haven't seen a dentist in several years, and the last time that I did, I ran away in tears.
Ooh, wonder vermin. You don't need the dentist.
I'm a raccoon, and I like to eat trash.
All the food I eat just happens to be fast. Live in little packs like a bandit firm. Don't touch me, you'll get ringworm. Creeping down the alley like a little spy. Porch light glinting in my yellow eyes. Outside your house, I will lurks. All my boyfriends turn out to be dicks.
Ooh, wonder Ooh, don't call that guy back.
I'm a damn possum, I'm slow and cautious. My prehensile tail makes people nauseous. When I get attacked, I have a fear fit. Secrete smelly fluids while I piss and shit. I've got 50 teeth for crushing and grinding, so I don't give a fuck what foods I'm finding. Snakes, rats, or carrion, I'll eat my fill. There's a reminder on my phone for me to take my pills.
Ooh, wonder vermin. Ooh, mood stabilizers.
I am a rat. I am fuzzy and cute. I make nests with trash and I eat my own poop. I get very sad without a cage mate, and I happen to think my banana tastes great. I often rewear my dirty undies. To show dominance, I'll mark you with pee!
Shelby, if you're gonna be cute about it, we're throwing you back in the piss grave.
Seriously.
I'm sorry, I just genuinely really love rats. I think they're so cute and fuzzy, and I want to just snuggle them and kiss their tiny little heads and boop their little snoots. And the part about the underwear work, right? That was good.
I mean, that was pretty gross.
Yeah.
And unsanitary.
Yeah.
Okay, just timing.
So we're creepy, crawly creatures of the night.
If you bring a joint, I'll have a light.
Come to the grave, we promise not to bite,
because we're wonder vermin and we're doing all right. Ooh, wonder vermin. Should have soaked the dishes. Wonder vermin, does this look infected? Wonder vermin, don't let the boy in. Wonder vermin, party at the piss grave.
Let's give it up again for Wonder Burger!
Turn two. What's gonna happen next? Very excited to bring to you this next act, guys. Let's all give it up for Pam H. Woo!
Hello. Hi, my name's Pam. I'm a performance artist and a visionary and a life coach and a healer and a herbalist, gerbilist. Connoisseur, commissor, the commissor. and a psychic medium, and performance artist. But I want to show you, if I could show you some of the performance art to start tonight, I would really like if I could have a volunteer. Is there anyone that would volunteer to come here and sit in this chair next to me? Please come. Hello, what's your name?
I'm Jess.
Hello. Are you ready? Thank you. I have one last demonstration. If I could have one more volunteer, please, to join me. You can come, yes. Thank you. What's your name? Henry. Hello, Henry. Are you sure this was a good idea, Henry? Okay, are you ready, Henry? Secrets to Spiritual Bliss They Don't Want You to Know About. Number 8 Will Blow Your Mind by Pam H. And it's got these secrets, but it's also a sort of a memoir that I've written in advance. So there's actually a chapter about tonight. Chapter 19, Eat More Vegetables. The crowd was astounded by Pam H. at the Pocket Theater and the mind-blowing display of the turtle, the duck, and the lizard. They all knew that their lives would never be the same again, but yet they wanted more. They wanted something only Pam H. could offer them. Many of them were sick, and they were in need of healing. And you guys are in luck, because I've actually got this. I brought a demonstration of my homeopathic Cure of the Month Club. This is a great deal. It's every month. It's $59.95 a month. I will drop one off at your door every month if you pay me that. It's a different cure every time. So I brought just a few examples. So this was from August. It's herpes. So if any of you had herpes, next August it should be herpes again. September is cholera. It's not a very popular disease, but if you had the herpes, you'll probably want this one too. October, so mumps, that's a good value. This one's empty, but it was syphilis for November this month. And then December, this one is for dehydration. It's just water. To be fair, all of these are 99.999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999 1.1111% was also water. So see me after the show if you're interested in that. I just have one more thing. I've been spending a lot of time with stand-up comedians, which is one of the worst things you can do. But I've been practicing. I think that maybe I should get into it. And I've been practicing a set, so if you guys don't mind, can I do a little set for you?
Yeah.
Just a second. I'll be right back. please welcome the number one standing comedian in the world, Pam H. How are you doing tonight? How are you doing? Hello. Hi, my name's Pam. I know what you're thinking. And yes, I am named after the cooking spray. like the cooking spray, I'm also buttery delicious and available for $3.99 at your local supermarket. Have you guys ever noticed stuff? What's the deal with that? Have I mentioned genitals yet? That seems to be a good one, usually. Starting to panic, you guys. I'm going to have to do an impression. And this is the current president of the United States, Ronald Reagan. Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall. Nancy and I think you should just say no to drugs. Thank you, that was Ronald Reagan. Alright, you guys, I think that's it. See me after the show about the... There'll be a book signed, and the book isn't available, but if anyone wants to watch me, I'll be up there.
beginning to lose something I always wanted. I'm setting it free to see if it comes back. The moment is long and I stare out for waiting for something to say. 15 years on, standing on that same shore, waiting for someone to open a door. The moment is long and I stare after it. Feel the ground slip away. If life is illusion, and we mere observers, then everything changes to follow our eyes. I'll walk on water, or wade through the walls. I'll wander through the wall to shake my own hand.
Sponsorships earlier that Josh mentioned, and I think it's only right for me to introduce our next guest, who I owe great personal debt to. It's my attorney. Sweaty D.
Presentation if you're lucky, so. Alright. So a lot of you have come here today and you're saying to yourself, Sweaty D, what is law? Come to the right place. I'm gonna tell you what law is. Law. L-A-W. Law. Law is a rule. We all gotta follow, right? that's what it is.
Yes.
What's a lawyer?
Good question.
If you take Y-E-R, which is Old English for your, and you add that to law, you get lawyer. That means your law. A lot of laws out there. One of them is going to be suitable for your situation. Absolutely. How does funny kid magic? Ooh. Good question. I'm going to show you how I work that magic. Now, I know this seems like an audience that likes to volunteer. May I have an audience member to come up here and just volunteer with Sweaty D? Potential lawyer client situation. Oh, please, 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 come on up. Thank you so much. Oh, what's your name?
Tasha.
Tasha, Tasha, all right. All right, so help me out here. Okay, so I need you to hold this here. Okay. Hold that blue Lady Liberty, you know. There you go, all right. No. All right, Tasha, you're my client here. That Slim Jim, that represents all the troubles, legally speaking, you've got going on. So you might say, Sweaty D! I've been involved in a vehicular accident. Oh, what kind? Fell off my bike. There's a solution for that. You sue the bike manufacturer. Why? Because no airbags! You take a smack into justice. That's what he does. Bike's a death trap. What's happening? What? I chopped down a tree in the park and got arrested. Seems bad, Tasha. Seems bad. You only chopped down that tree because of self-defense! Snapping at justice! Coach Hugh's gonna attack you with power. Dangerous. Oh, gosh. Ah, Sweaty D! Uh-huh. Phone ringing off the hook. Gonna get a couple chews in. Gonna pick up the old red phone there. Sweaty D! Huh? Got arrested!
For what?
Illegally importing exotic animals! Huh. You were hitchhiking. And that snow leopard pulled up in his truck. You offered to drive, you took a nap in the back! Snapping at justice! That's what you do! You're free! Thank you so much! That's just what he does! Justice! Spicy, greasy, and delicious! That's what it is. Sweaty D, how do I contact you? Oh, thanks for asking. 1-900-WIN-D's. D-E-E-S. Just give me a call. Tell me your situation is. Well, Sweaty's gonna listen. And then you just take one of these envelopes and just put your evidence in there. Drop it in there. Well-constructed envelope. And just give a couple licks. And you fold that up and then. Okay. You might as well lick it a lot. You wanna get. Well, my. A little seal is simple, so you just tape it up. You sealed it. Huh, okay. Seal that up. Oh, God.
Melt into you.
I want to be
so connected. Like the most connected of people. Like 100% completely connected. I want to be sewn together so that we can always be together.
How's that?
How? Oh, you mean like how our bodies, like front to front. I hadn't thought about it. Good question.
I see.
Oh, how about this? How about I unzip my skin from my body, peel it off, and then you would unzip, you know, your skin from your body, and then I could step into your skin and peel it up over my body. And then you can step into my skin. Push it up onto your body. Oh God. We can really feel what it's like to be inside of each other.
You are a strange one. But you are kind of cute.
I still wish I could lay like this forever.
I wish I could die and then be reincarnated as your unborn baby.
My unborn baby?
Yeah, think about it. Then I could know what it's like to be completely immersed inside of you for 9 months. And then think about it. When you gave birth to me, my face would push out through your beautiful, delicious, flowery.
Stop. Nope. Nope.
No, what's wrong?
Nope. No, thank you.
Babe.
I think I can lay like here forever.
Me too. Me too.
True crime again? That stuff messes you up. I'm worried about you.
3 women are killed in America every day by their husbands and their boyfriends.
Carrie, I told you. I love you. I'm not gonna hurt you. Maybe you should go take a shower.
Oh, that would make for an easy cleanup.
You do what you want. I'm gonna start making dinner.
Oh, hey, let me help. I can cut those vegetables.
No need for you to hold a knife. Sure, I mean, I'm still worried about you, but I could use the help, so I'll take it. Hold on to the knife. How was your day?
Same old, the office. Karen, she tried to blame me for some BS, but I still got to work on the Thompson project, so it's okay.
She's so frustrating.
She really makes you mad.
It's like she's out to get me.
Maybe you should get her before she gets you.
Yeah. No, wait, no.
I could help you get rid of her.
Maybe you should go take that shower.
I can help clean it up. I picked up some bleach and some garbage bags at the store.
What?
Hey, don't worry, I paid cash.
Maybe you should go. Maybe you should go take a shower.
Uh-oh. It's you or me, Tom. I ain't about to die. I've done some research. You took insurance out on me.
I was just adding you to my car insurance.
You've been going to the gym so you can overpower me?
I just gained a little weight. All you want to do is watch true crime on the couch.
So you do want to get rid of me? 3 women die every day by their boyfriends.
Stop it. I love you. Calm down.
Not today. I am ready.
Why?
3 women die every day.
Good night.